We span the globe to uncover a wide range of sports news and features. If you like the sound of that, you've come to the right place. Hello and welcome to Sports United, coming up on the show. We slide over to the Women's Curling World Championship. We take a look at SportAccord's man on a mission. And we go cross-court and discover the rules of squash. The 37th edition of the Women's Curling World Championship took place at Sapporo in Japan. Holders Switzerland and heavyweights Canada reached the final for a repeat of last year's showpiece match. Switzerland were hunting their third world title in 4 years, while Canada were looking to extend their record gold medal tally to 16.
It was the third meeting of these two teams at this year's championship, with Switzerland having won both previous matchups in the round robin and the playoffs. The start of the final didn't give much hope of reversing the fortunes of Jennifer Jones's Canada, who fell behind 4-0 after six ends. Swiss skip Alina Petz and her team had complete control of the tie, and despite Canada scoring 2 points in the seventh and one more in the ninth, Petz held the hammer, or the final stone, in the last end to see out a 5-3 victory. Russia thrashed Scotland 13-4 to win the bronze medal for the second straight year. It meant the podium was identical to that of last year's championships, as a beaming Switzerland team held aloft their third world trophy from the past 4 years.
After Qatar, the second fencing Grand Prix of the season in the épée discipline took place at Budapest in Hungary. The event gathered over 500 of the world's best, but there could only be one winner from each of the men's and ladies' draw.
After making a stunning comeback to win through his semi-final earlier in the day, 44-year-old Cuban-born Frenchman Ivan Trevejo appeared spent when facing Nikolai Novosiolov in the final. Novosiolov, a two-times world champion from Estonia, breezed through the encounter, highlighting the 9 years difference in age between the pair. He was rarely threatened and comfortably saw out a 15-6 victory to strike gold. In the ladies' final, Romania's Anna Maria Branza and Shin Alam of South Korea could hardly get on the scoreboard. After regulation time, the score was 4-4, but Shin came to life in extra time, adding another 5 points to win through 9-5 for her first success of the season. The next Épée Grand Prix is in Rio de Janeiro, starting on the 22nd of May. Thank you.
The XCAT World Series is becoming more and more popular as the seasons roar past. With twin V6 engines, these powerboats are capable of reaching speeds of 120 miles an hour. It's Formula One on water. The 2015 season just saw round two chop up the waves in Dubai. After the Fujairah opener, the World Series stayed in the United Arab Emirates for the second stop in Dubai. Following a poor start to the season, last year's series champions ex-Dubai had something to prove on their second straight home waters race. Pilots Arif Al-Zafain and Nadir Bin Hendi strategically decided to complete their obligatory long lap immediately, leaving the rest to power out in front. But they steadily made their way through the field to catch up on race leaders T-Bone Station and Fujairah winners Abu Dhabi. On the penultimate lap, ex-Dubai manoeuvred their way into the lead and stayed there to cross the line for victory, with Abu Dhabi second. Abu Dhabi remain at the top of the general standings, ahead of round three in Europe in May. Marius Vizer is a man on a mission to increase visibility, exposure and recognition for all sports under his umbrella. Recently in Moscow, we caught up with the president of SportAccord, the association of all Olympic and non-Olympic sports federations, to find out just a little bit more about him and his ambitions.
The sport is my life. I can say that I grew up in the sport. I was an athlete. I'm totally dedicated, especially in the last period of my life, to the sport. I started the judo. Integrity, anti-doping, good governance, marketing, media, management, administration. I am convinced when the International Federation will follow, like the judo have trusted to me, we will achieve the best results. Just a solution how to generate more money for the sport, more exposure, more credibility and attractivity for some of the sport. Challenging the youngs and the new generations to practicing sport. Because the sport, it's a competition. Very challenging project. I am ready.
Born out of the game rackets, squash was invented at Harrow School in England around 1830. Pupils discovered that the punctured ball, which squashed on impact with the wall, required a greater variety of shots and skill to hit. Today, the sport is played by over 20 million people worldwide. If you want to add yourself to that number, here's a few basic rules to get you started. Before you begin playing, of course, warm yourself up and the ball. Also check which ball to use according to your level. During play, the ball can hit anywhere below the top line or outline and above the bottom line, which is also called the tin. When serving, one foot must be inside the box, the ball must hit the wall between the outline and the service line and land in the opposite quarter. After every shot, try to get back to the tee zone. That will give you the best position to cover the next shot. After playing a shot, you need to get out of the way of your opponent. If you try and fail, it's a let and the point is replayed. If you don't try, your opponent wins the point. A game is up to 11, but you must win by 2 points. A match is the best of 5 games.
We end the show with some stunning action from Istanbul, where the 50th running of the European Karate Championships recently took place. Enjoy the clip, and from all the Sports United team here, thanks for watching, and we'll see you all again next week. Goodbye.